Right. This is David Sheely. Hey, I wanted to make a short video for you today to help include you in the process of the narration of book 3 of the Drosselmeyer series. And actually, I forgot to bring the book with me. I'll be right back. There we go. Let's go back in here. There we go. All right. Brought the books with me. So what we're working on is, the audiobooks for, I should rephrase that. This is the Nutcracker trilogy written by Paul Thompson. It's The Curse of the Rat King, The Watcher's Realm, and Dance of the Nutcracker. And I realized I just pointed those and you couldn't see them. Sorry. So books 1 and 2 are already available through Audible and Apple Books. Hopefully more services coming soon. But now we're going to work on book 3, Dance of the Nutcracker. This is where the story all comes together, of course. You know, it's been leading up to the story of Drosselmeyer and his part in the Nutcracker Ballet. So this is the story that tells that. I gotta say, I enjoyed book 3 more than any of the others. This is definitely my favorite. This one's very exciting. Lots of action. Not a lot of magic, actually. For a book about wizards, there's not a lot of actual magic use in book 2 or 3. Now, I don't want to discourage you. There is some. Of course, you know, if you're here for a wizard story, you want some magic. So there is some. Don't worry. You won't be disappointed. But I really enjoyed this one. So I've got with me, I have my iPad here in front of me and my computer's off to the side. Got some coffee. And what I want to do is I just want to read the prologue of the book to you. My hope is that throughout the recording process, I can include you as part of that process. Now, I won't be reading the full book, recorded on video. You're just going to get little snippets here and there, but, I wanted to engage you and pique your interest. And hopefully because of one of these videos you see, you'll think, man, I want to check out these stories. So, all right, that's the goal. Prologue. A figure rose from behind the smooth rock and turned to face Fritz. He was tall and broad. His hair fell in golden ringlets to his shoulders. The curves of his muscled chest and arms were only half hidden by his white tunic. The gold trim of his outfit matched the golden circlet on his head. See, already got a little frog in my throat. Hopefully some warm coffee will help resolve that issue. So when recording, obviously I would stop there and cut that part out and re-record it. So you're getting a little sneak behind the curtain, as it were. To see what it looks like when I'm recording. I do want to mention these aren't intended to be how-to videos. It's just that behind the curtain look, the behind the scenes, right? So don't expect to get detailed step 1, step 2, here's how to create your own audiobook. That's not the intention of these videos, but let's try that again. A figure rose from behind the smooth rock and turned to face Fritz. He was tall and broad. His hair fell in golden ringlets to his shoulders. The curves of his muscled chest and arms were only half hidden by his white tunic. The gold trim of his outfit matched the golden circlet on his head. "Who are you?" he asked. His voice was mellow yet commanding. "My name is Drosselmeyer," he hesitated. See, I messed up again. And I apologize. I keep looking over the computer screen because I just not experienced with this, right? With the recording process, apparently. So, let's try that line again. My name is Drosselmeyer. Fritz hesitated, turning his eye patch toward the statuesque man. I see you do not bow in my presence, the man observed, more to himself than to Fritz. And the clothes you wear are not of this world. He circled Fritz, his steps slow and plodding, and his expression showing nothing more than extreme amusement. Where are you from? The Central Kingdom, Fritz replied. The man squinted ever so slightly. So you do not know who I am? Let me try that again. So, you do not know who I am? He sounded bored, on the verge of a yawn. No, sir, Fritz said, dipping his head in a polite gesture. Forgive my ignorance. The man stopped pacing, and Fritz turned to face him. The air around him shimmered, and his white robe shed golden sparks of light. Fritz shrank back from the imposing figure, enamored of and terrified by his demeanor. Are you the Watcher? And there you have it. That's the prologue. So I'll let you in on a little secret. I actually wasn't recording to the actual audiobook. You know, this is day one of recording book number three. It's been a few months since I've recorded, so I got to get back in the groove of things. But like I said, I wanted you to invite you behind the curtain into my recording studio, which is my closet. I mean, nothing fancy, but it seems to work okay for this purpose. So... that's video number one. We read the prologue together of Drosselmeyer, Dance of the Nutcracker. And stay tuned, because I'm hoping to share some more snippets with you soon. All right. Thanks. See you in the next one.